And here is the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday, the 25th of December, 2019. It is Christmas Day, a day that has been shaped by many writers, particularly by Charles Dickens. In Victorian England, back in the 19th century, old Christmas traditions were fading away, particularly the observance of 12 days of Christmas had passed by the boards. And Dickens believed that a revival of Christmas traditions would promote social harmony in Great Britain. He had known Christmas as a jolly time of games and dancing and wine and Christmas pudding and roasted goose. And he put all of these elements into his novella, A Christmas Carol. And also an appeal to care for the less fortunate. The story was such a success that Dickens found himself obligated to write a new Christmas story every year for years afterward, which he grumbled about, though he truly did love Christmas. His son said of Dickens, "My father was always at his best at Christmas, a splendid host, bright and jolly as a boy and throwing his heart and soul into everything that was going on. And then the dance, there was no stopping him." It was on this day, 1956, that the novelist Harper Lee spent Christmas in New York City with her friends Michael and Joy Brown, who gave her a gift that changed her life. She was working as a ticket agent at an airline, and they gave her an envelope that said, "You have 1 year off from your job to write whatever you please. Merry Christmas." And it wasn't a joke. They really meant it. And she used that year to write the first draft of what would become To Kill a Mockingbird. And it's the day that St. Francis of Assisi created the first nativity scene in Greccio, Italy in 1223, a living nativity scene with an ass and a donkey and some villagers playing Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus. And he staged the whole thing in a cave outside of town. And it drew a great crowd, and Francis preached about the babe of Bethlehem, and the nativity scene became a tradition in Italy and elsewhere. It is Christmas Day. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow wrote, "I heard the bells on Christmas Day their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men." Sir Walter Scott wrote, "'Twas Christmas broached the mightiest ale, 'twas Christmas told the merriest tale. A Christmas gamble oft could cheer the poor man's heart through half the year." And it was Irving Berlin who wrote, "'I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.'" Here's a poem for today by Robin Richstone, The Christmas Story. We know by heart these stories of a cold world unwelcoming in the murderous tyrant, Mary on a donkey. Escape, how cruel, how long ago, how far from what we mean to sing, O come to the weary, the terrified, Mary's heart beating fast, her grip on the baby, the strains of it, fill the shops, the streets, flow down rivers, cross seas, cross borders. The refugee mother kneels to change her infant in an open field, the shepherds gone, the angels quiet, her safety now completely up to us. The Christmas Story, a poem by Robin Richstone from the Museum of Fresh Starts, published by Leah Maines and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and a very Merry Christmas.